Hello, I'm Rachel, and this is the electric airplane I'm building. Recently, I've been working in the aft section of the fuselage, where the main gear will be installed. There's quite a bit here, so let's get to it. When I built the fuselage sides, I installed this long triangular piece of spruce as the lower longeron. Near the aft end, you need to square up the lower longeron, which you do by adding a length of triangular spruce to make it square. The cozy plans have you leave that abrupt edge from triangular profile to square until chapter 9, which I'm on now, when, as part of preparing the fuselage for the main gear, you're supposed to smooth out that transition. That was the first thing I did here. I used a small straight edge to draw guidelines for me to cut to with my oscillating multi-tool. After getting a rough cut, I switched to a sanding attachment and smoothed it out. After smoothing out the lower longeron transition, I sanded the forward landing gear attach bulkhead, as well as parts of the fuselage sides and floor, to aid with the mechanical bond of the reinforcement layups in this area. After sanding the area down, I used a marker to, you know, mark down where I'm going to add reinforcements. Then I took some paper and used that to figure out a template for the fiberglass. Then I cut some strips of fiberglass, sketched the template onto them, and cut rough lengths that were much more manageable. For the layup, I mixed epoxy, of course. I used a finger to apply a flox corner to smooth out the inside corners between the fuselage side and the bulkhead. Then I brushed an epoxy coating onto the area and cut the fiberglass to the desired shape and fit it into place. Then I stippled an epoxy for the layup. Have three plies of bid sides. Then another 2 plies of bid over each hardpoint. Then repeat again for the other side. After laying up both sides, I put peel ply over everything. Once this epoxy cured, I cleaned it up. I used my trusty oscillating multi-tool to remove the excess from the edges. Then I spent quite some time removing this fiberglass over the electrical channel. And that's the reinforcement layups for the forward face of the gear attach box. Next, we're going to move further aft and reinforce the interior of the gear attach box, starting with yet more sanding to flatten everything and ensure a good mechanical bond of the layup. As with earlier, marking where the fiberglass will go and creating a paper template for the fiberglass. Unlike the last layup, where I needed to do the layup in situ in order to keep the darts from being all in the same place, this time I don't have that restriction, meaning I could do most of the layup on the table and then transfer that to the gearbox interior, which is simpler, faster, and much easier on my back. As for actually transferring that, again, I painted on some epoxy to the surface first and added a bead of micro to smooth the interior corners. With that, I can take the larger layup, 3 plies a bit, and install it in place. After the larger 3-ply bid layup was transferred, I then transferred this smaller 2-ply bid layup over. Once those layups are installed, Then it's just a matter of placing some peel ply over the fiberglass and some plastic sheeting and towels to help apply some pressure over the area to keep it in place and to prevent air bubbles. Off camera, I repeated this process for the other side. After both layups cured, I again used my trusty oscillating multi-tool to cut off the excess fiberglass. I had to do some repair work on the port side, so I sanded down the area. And installed a couple patches of fiberglass to fix this error. Then I put on some peel ply and again used towels and some weights to ensure that the fiberglass stayed in place and didn't develop any air bubbles. This repair work turned out fine, but I don't have any footage of the cleanup. Instead, let's move on and focus on the area between the aft gear attach bulkhead and the firewall. Because I'll be doing work where the fuselage attaches to the rotisserie, I unmounted the fuselage from the rotisserie. I vacuumed up any debris that was in there, and got to work marking where the reinforcement layup would go. Then I got to work sanding. It's pretty tight quarters here, so I ended up doing a lot of hand sanding. Where possible, I use a sanding attachment on my trusty oscillating multi-tool. Then you can see me making three more templates for the three different shapes I'll be installing here. And then yet more sanding. This is with mostly 36 grit sandpaper, though the sandpaper discs I'm hand sanding with are at 50 grit. At this rough of a grit, I'm more roughing up the surface than I am smoothing it out. This is what aids in creating a mechanical bond for the reinforcement layers to grip onto. And onto the actual layup. I laid up all the fiberglass at once, which is fine because I exclusively use the slow hardener with my epoxy. This gives me about 6 hours of working time before it starts to set, so I'm in no rush here. Once all this fiberglass was laid up, I went over to the fuselage and spread wet micro over the exposed foam. The glass bubbles in the micro fills in the voids in the foam, which greatly helps with adhesion. Once that was done, I used some thicker but still wet micro to radius the inside corners. Then I grabbed the first of the sheets of fiberglass. This is 2 plies of bid and it goes over this center area. Then I moved the next layups. Which are 3 plies of bid around the outside edges following the inside of the fuselage sides. Finally, I moved to the last of these reinforcement layups, which are 3 plies of bid and cover the hard points of the aft gear attached bulkhead up to the equivalent area on the firewall. Then I put on peel ply, but this camera overheated, so you'll have to trust me that I peel plied everywhere. Once this all cured, I removed the peel ply, which I don't have video of, but it came out looking like this. With all the reinforcement layups done, the last thing to do is open up the 1/4-inch bolt holes for the gear. The plans also call for you to open up some 1-inch holes that'll be used by the aileron torque tubes, but I'll do that when I install the aileron torque tubes down the line. Once these were opened up, I deburred the holes. Okay, next up is... Oh, this is already 19 minutes long? Okay then. Well, that's step 1 of chapter 9 of the cozy plans. Only... 5 more to go? Well, alright. Next up, I'll be working in the main gear strut itself. If you like this and want to see more, please leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Until next time, thank you, and I hope you have a great day.